We are not trying to test their knowledge. We are not trying to test their education. We only want to give the judges one last chance to review their impressions and refresh their memories of last week's interviews.
Ang Miss Universe ay isang pandaigdigang paligsahan sa kagandahan na nagsimula noong 1952. Sa paglipas ng mga taon, ang paligsahan ay nag-evolve, kabilang na ang bahagi ng question and answer. Tingnan natin kung paano nga ba nagbago ang format na ito mula sa panahon ni Gloria Diaz at Margie Moran hanggang sa panahon ni Pia Wurtzbach at Catriona Gray. Sa panahon ng mga unang Miss Universe, ang question and answer portion ay mas nakatuon sa pagiging praktikal. Ang mga tanong ay kadalasang tungkol sa mga pangkalahatang kaalaman or general knowledge. At ang mga sagot ay inaasahang magiging magalang, matikas at nagpapakita ng katalinuhan. Panoorin natin ang Q&A portion ni Miss Universe Gloria Diaz at Margie Moran noong 1969 and 1973.
We have now reached the final phase of tonight's competition. A chance for our judges to watch all of our Miss Universe finalists in an informal answer and question situation. Now, each of these five finalists will be asked a question of general interest. We are not trying to test their knowledge. We are not trying to test their education. We only want to give the judges one last chance to review their impressions and refresh their memories of last week's interviews. Now, we have interpreters standing by so that each girl may answer the question in her own language if she wishes, and the answer will be translated for us.
Miss Philippine, step right up here. Right up here. And you speak English well, I know that. Miss Philippines, in the next day or so, a man will land on the moon. If a man from the moon landed in your hometown, what would you do to entertain him?
Oh, just the same things I do. I think if he's been in the moon for so long, I think when he comes over, he wants a change, I guess.
Very good, Miss Philippines.
This is the remaining question. This question is for you. Your question is, let's make believe that all of a sudden, this is a perfect question for her. Let's make believe that all of a sudden you had $1 million. What's the first thing you would buy and why would you buy it?
A house and lot. Because it's the most expensive thing and I can't afford it. So if I had $1 million, I'll buy a house and lot and live by myself and other people, of course.
Thank you very much, Miss Philippines.
Sa mga nakaraang taon naman, ang question and answer portion ay naging mas makabuluhan at mas personal. Ang mga tanong ay kadalasang tungkol sa mga isyung panlipunan, politika, edukasyon, at pangkapaligiran. At ang mga sagot ay inaasahang magiging matapat, makabuluhan, at nagpapakita ng malalim na pag-unawa sa mga issue. Panoorin naman natin ang Q&A portion ni Miss Universe Pia Wurtzbach at Catriona Gray taong 2015 and 2018.
What is the most important lesson you've learned in your life, and how would you apply it to your time as Miss Universe?
I work a lot in the slums of Tondo, Manila, and the life there is it's poor and it's very sad. And I've always taught myself to look for the beauty in it, to look in the beauty in the faces of the children, and to be grateful. And I would bring this aspect as a Miss Universe to see situations with a silver lining and to assess where I could give something, where I could provide something as a spokesperson. And this, I think, if I could teach also people to be grateful, we could have an amazing world where negativity could not grow and foster, and children would have a smile on their face. Thank you.
Thank you, Philippines. Here we are. Why should you be the next Miss Universe?
To be a Miss Universe is both an honor and a responsibility. If I were to be Miss Universe, I will use my voice to influence the youth, and I would raise awareness to certain causes like HIV awareness that is timely and relevant to my country, which is the Philippines. I want to show the world, the universe rather, that I am confidently beautiful with a heart. Thank you.
Well, thank you all.
Sa pangkalahatan, ang question and answer portion ng Miss Universe ay nag-evolve mula sa isang pagsubok sa katalinuhan at kagandahan tungo sa isang plataforma para sa pagpapahayag ng mga pananaw at pagtataguyod ng mga issue. At higit sa lahat, ang mga kandidata ay hindi lamang inaasahang magiging maganda at matalino, kundi inaasahan din silang magkaroon ng malalim na pag-unawa sa mga isyung panlipunan at magkaroon ng boses para sa pagbabago. At kung nagustuhan mo ang ating video ngayon, huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe para updated sa next upload natin.